So last time we were with this A16 overstrewing arrangement. So was just going to show you some diagram. So this is the diagram. You can see that here. So here is the baggage grain. This one, the grains are over here, and this one is 1/16 B or 1/12. And separation cloth or a wooden boards are there. So this is the bulk grains being loaded. Then here it is covered with the separation cloth and then overstored. Or here the wooden's battens, what was like as were like 25 meter boards and 100 mm, and these were 1.2 meters apart, was laid up. And this is how it is being done. 1.2 meters, then the height. This height is showing over 1/16th of the breadth of the free grain surface, and 1.2 meters, whichever is greater, is here. This height over here, this one is showing, and the separation cloth and the boards were kept over here. So this is how it is being kept over here, and this is for the bundling. This is for also bundling. This is saucering. This is saucering. This is saucering. Okay, so now we will go to strapping and lashing. Strapping or lashing. So there are two types. This is strapping or lashing, as well as wire mesh lashing. They have this two one. So what is there is when in order to eliminate the healing moment in partly filled. So this is for the partly filled, because this bundling and saucering and overstrewing is also for the partly filled. The 16 overstrewing is for partly filled, whereas bundling and saucering is for the completely filled. So strapping and lashing method is for partly filled compartment. So what is written is the grain shall be trimmed and leveled to the extent that it is very slightly crowned and covered with a burlap separation cloth. So why it is crowned? Because it is written here to crown. So we crown, and then firstly it should be crowned. Then the separation cloth at the tarpaulins overlap at least 1.8 meters. So overlapping means on, let's say that here this one is one tarpaulin, the other one should be such that it will be covered like this on the other one. And this covered, whatever is this here covered, shall be at least 1.8 meters and shall not be less than 1.8 meters. Then two solid floors of rough 25 mm by 150 mm to 300 mm lumbers should be used, shall be laid with the top floor running longitudinally and nailed to the earthwork. So it is two solid floors, one above and one below, shall be laid with the top floor running longitudinally. So top floor, here it is written top floor running longitudinally, and the bottom one shall be earthward. So we will put in the bottom earthward shape, this lumbers, that is 25 mm by 150 to 300 mm bottom floors. Alternative, one solid floor of 50 mm lumber running longitudinally and nailed at the top of the 50 mm bottom bearing, not less than 150 meter wide. The bottom bear shall be extending with the full breadth of the Here, the bottom shall be bearing with a shell full extent of the breadth of the compartment and shall be spaced not more than 2.4 meters apart. So what is there is, we made a crown, then we put a tarpaulin, and tarpaulin size cannot be as big as like a hole, so it should be overlapped by 1.8 meter. And then over that first earthward chip we will put our dunnages or lumbers, 25 into 150 to 300 mm, and then longitudinally we will fit. Then after Okay, this 50 can be also alternative because this is written alternative, it is. So it can be alternatively placed in case that is not available. So, and then that should be bought, that whatever we will make, that should be at least a space of 2.4 meters apart. This means it is something like this, that it is like this, and this one is also like this. So in these two, 2.4 meters of the breadth, 2.4 meters apart they should be. So that's what. Then steel wire rope of 19 mm. So steel wire shall be used with a 19 mm of diameter, and or steel strap, double steel strap, that is 50 mm, 1.3 mm, and having a breaking load of at least 49 kilonewtons. Double steel strapping. If chain is used, so chain of an equivalent strength, and each shall be at least tightened by means of 32 mm. Turnbuckles may be used for the lashing. A winch tightener used in conjunction with the locking arm may be suitable for the 32 mm turnbuckle. When a steel strap, okay, so it is having not much, that is steel wire of 19 mm will be used, and strap of 50 cross 1.3 mm, which is having 49 kilonewtons of the 49 kilonewton breaking load. Or if strap is not used, then chain can be used of equivalent strength and a 32 mm turnbuckle, which will be connected with the help of the steel wire. So what is that? First burlap we have laid up, and on the top of that earthward shaped dunnages, then longitudinal dunnages, and then over that we will put straps, which is 50 mm into 1.3 mm, or the straps we can put, as well as we can put the steel, chains of equivalent strength, which will be connected with the help of the turnbuckles. Now we go move on. Prior to the completion of the loading, the lashing shall be positively attached to the framing at the point approximately 450 mm below. Okay, and the anticipation, finally, grain surface by the means of 25 mm shackle. So the shackle shall be 25 mm. The lashing shall be spaced not more than 2.4 meters. Okay. Apart, and each shall be supporting by a bearing nail and all this. Okay. Lumbers not less than 25 mm by 150 mm. Okay, so it is, I'll show with the diagram that so as to understand better one. So this one is, yeah, here. So here, what is this? First grain is there, crown is made, and then this is tarpaulin which is first placed, then this is earthward shape, this is longitudinal, this tonnage is here, it is written, and then over that the strappings are placed with the help of the turnbuckle here, and here is also shackle of 25 mm, like here will be shackle of 25 mm, which will go 450 mm below, because everything shall be connected with this one. No? So 450 mm will be below, but the shackle shall be there, or something shall be there which can be used. Okay, so here, as you can see, that tarpaulin was placed, and tarpaulin overlapping 1.8, and then we put two earthward shape and longitudinal tonnages. Thereafter we have this steel wire of diameter, this one, and a double steel strapping, this one, or chain. So tarpaulin, earthward, longitudinal. Now from here, this is 450 mm down, here is one shackle, and here what I want to show you is here, which is written 450 mm below, and the anticipation final grain by the means of either 25 mm shackle or a beam clamp of equivalent strength. So this thing, what is here is 25 mm or a beam strap, whatever it has been written over, 25 mm shackle or a beam clamp. So it is here, and 450 mm it is the distance below which it is placed, and then from here the wire rope can come up, then straps, or from here the straps can come or the chains can come. So wire rope can be also there, or strap can be there, or chain can be there. And then this chains, this is earthward shape. If we will look from the top, so this wire rope or the strap shall not be more than 2.4 meters away from each other. That is the distance between this one and the other one, which may be, let's say, bird eye view. So it will be somewhere here. So it should not be more than that one, 2.4 meter. That is okay. And here we have something else. Here also you can see this is 450 mm, then 1.8 meter it is this is overlapping. Then steel wire is 19 mm, this one is steel wire. Then lumbers are here, turnbuckle is here, bearing board, that is lumbers again here, and this is four clamps on the wire connection. So, and this is 25 mm shackle, as you can see over here, this one. So this is four clamps on the wire connections also we have to put, because otherwise the, and here also we have to put a same number four. Okay, now we have the other one. Okay, now securing with mesh, wire mesh. So it is also for the partly filled up. And the grain shall be trimmed, same shall be trimmed and leveled to the extent to a very slightly crowned. So this is why it is crowned, because it is written crowned. So the entire surface of the grain shall be covered with a burlap separation cloth. The covering material shall be tensile strength or not less than 1.34 newton per 5 centimeters strip. So it is same 1344 which was before. So crowned, and then burlap we have placed. Thereafter, two layers of wire. How many layers? Two layers. Two layers of wire mesh shall be laid on the top of the burlap. This one, and then the, okay, now the length of the wire mesh are to be overlapped at least 75 mm. So overlapping 75 mm. The top layer of the mesh to be polished over the bottom layer in such a manner that, okay, alternative approximately 75 mm by 75 mm. Okay, the wire mesh is the type of used in the reinforced concrete construction. So this is used in concrete construction. So shall be so much powerful. It is fabricated of that the wire mesh which is used is 3 mm diameters. Breaking stress strength is not less than 32 kN per centimeter square. And the square which is formed by the wire mesh is 150 mm cross 150 mm squares. Okay. So this is like 1, 2, 3, 4. So this one is one wire, and one wires. So this one wire shall not be less than, shall be at least 3 mm. This one, 3 mm in diameter. Then this square should be 150 mm cross 150 mm. And when it is overlapped with another one, then it is 75 mm. So this is how it should be. And then The boundary of the wire mesh at port and starboard side of the compartment shall be retained by wood planks 150 mm cross 50 mm. So it is port and starboard side. Port and total starboard. This means throughout the length. Hold down lashing running from side to side across the compartment shall be spaced not more than 2.4 meters apart, except that the first and the last lashing shall not be more than 300 mm from forward or aft bulkhead. So that is port and starboard side. Let's say that this is our starboard side. So full length I place up here. One full length. It cannot be like this because it is hanged up. Okay, let's say. The two layers of wire reinforced mesh shall be laid on the top of the burlap, and then the length of the wire mesh shall be overlaid by at least 75 mm overlapping. Then square is 150 mm cross 150 mm squares. Okay, and the boundary of the wire mesh at the port and starboard side. Port and starboard side is with a wooden plank of 150 mm cross 50 mm, and then we are over here. The hold down lashing running from side to side across the compartment shall be spaced not more than 2.4 meter apart. That is, all whatever will be lashing shall be at least 2.4 meters apart. And the first here, except the first and the last lashing, should not be more than 300 mm from the forward and aft of the bulkhead. Okay. Prior to the completion of the loading, each lashing shall be positively attached to the framing at the point approximately 450 mm below the anticipated grain surface by 25 mm shackles and all this. So okay, I was just checking. So 450 mm below by 25 mm shackles, beam clamped of the equivalent strength, the lashing shall be let from the point over the top of the boundary plank described in this one. Okay, so function distribution and all this, and two layers of 150 mm cross 25 mm plans shall be laid. Okay, the hold down lashing shall consist of the steel wire rope, that is 19 mm wire rope, and double steel strap if it is used. So 50 cross 1.3 mm breaking strength, that is 49 with a turnbuckle of 32 mm. Okay, and the turnbuckle actually shall be till half, that is it should be half should be left so that it can be tightened up during the voyage. So I will show you this one is over here. So it is same like this only, but to use that. Wire mesh. So it is here actually. It was not opening up. So this is the figure of one of the wire mesh slashing, that how it is done. You can see over here, this is overlapping is done over here, and then here you can see this lumbers are there, and with the wire ropes they are tightening up. So this is how it will be. So it will be something like grain is already been loaded, then burlap separation cloth has been placed up and shall not be less than 1344. This means this 2867 we can use this one also, this one. Then two layers of the wire ropes to be wires to be used, and that should be at least 3 mm in diameter with 52 kilonewton strength or more, that it should not be less than. Then 150 meters of the square shall be made. Okay, now we know this one. And then also how to do this one about the plank. This means that the boundary of the wire mesh port and starboard side of the compartment shall be retained with the wooden planks 150 cross 50 mm. So this is, let's say, starboard. So throughout this one I made like this with the wooden plank, then port and starboard. Throughout this one we made it finish. Okay, now side to side across the compartment shall be spaced 2.4 meter. Okay, and shall not be more than 300 mm from forward and aft bulkhead. So 300 mm is about 30 centimeters. So 30 centimeters like this, I place one, means this is actually throughout, like this, like this, like this, like this, and this, like this, and it is 300 mm over here. So this space is 300 mm, that is 30 centimeters. And then I put up on from the bottom also like this here, and then it is still here. So this is 300 mm, this is 300 mm. These are the planks. Actually this yellow, this one is plank, this is planks, this is planks, this is plank, this is planks. So everything is plank. And below this wire mesh is already of this, like wire mesh of like this, of like this and like this. So this square is 150 mm cross 150 mm. This wire is 3 mm diameter, which is been there. So it is all lying down. So this is our wooden planks, this is wooden planks. Now here the wire row will go, wire row will go of 19 mm, which will be 4 point, that is the wire rope of 19 mm, 450 mm below, and with the 25 mm shackles. So 25 mm shackles, I was shown this one before also, it is over here, this shackle here down is 25 mm, or here also this shackle over here, this one is 25 mm. So this will go, wire rope will come, and the wire rope will go over this one like this, over here to here and to here. Now on the other ones, that should be wooden planks shall be placed. It should be placed such that it is like this throughout the length of the compartment, and the distance between these two shall not be more than 2.4 decimal 4. So this one distance between this one is like this, how the wooden plank has been placed. This should be also placed throughout, from earthward shape, throughout earthward shape of the compartment, and the distance space shall not be more than 2.4 meter. That is, if this will be there, so it should not be more than, here it is written, not more than 2.4 meter. Like this we have to place this one, And here it is written 19mm wire ropes and all this, or the double strappers if you want to use. So it will be 50mm into 1.3mm and 49 kilonewtons should be breaking strength, 32mm that is. So this is all about the slashings, and for the calculation is given in part B of the grain code. So these are some of the important things just to go through if somebody wants like how to calculate exactly. I will put up in the comment that you wanted, so I'll put that video also, or maybe after a few days I will put that video also. So this one is VD is equal to VD1 plus 0.75 D minus 600 mm, VD is equal to what, and VD1 and D is equal to what. As you can see, VD is the average void depth and VD1 is the standard void depth as given in table B11. Okay, we will see this B11 table is this here. So we can see over here this B11, and D is the actual girder depth in millimeters, and in no case VD shall be assumed to be less than 100 mm. So BB1 is given over here, the distance from the hatch end to the hatch side of the boundary of the compartment, and standard void depths is given over here. These are few diagrams. Okay, this one I want to show. This one. This total healing movement is 1.06 into calculated transverse healing movement. This is for the filled compartment, and total healing movement is 1.12 into calculated transverse healing movement. This is for the partly filled compartment. Sitting over here. So this is for the partly filled. So sometimes people say 1.1 is for, or 1 is for full, I don't know from where, but the code says this thing only, these two. What is other can be ship specific or can be anything else, or can be on the which basis, I don't know. Assumption of the volumetric healing movement and filled trimming. This means, I mean to say that part B is full about the calculations, the how to calculate and how to calculate the your final stability conditions and all this, that the vessel is holding good and she is upright to go. Assumption, assumed volume heating movement of a filled compartment and untrimmed. So these all here also, the resulting grain surface abreast of the hatch cover shall be assumed to be an angle of 15 degrees to the horizontal, and then here is 25 degrees to the horizontal, and this is all. So nothing more.